So this is part two. Make sure you watch part one about the destruction of this park. And this guy here is a guy who just picked up the toilets. And this is for the Terry Fox run. Run for the cure, they call it. Yeah, cure what? You're destroying our park. And all we've got is tire marks, garbage everywhere. And this is all for an event that only lasts a few hours. They do months and months and months of destruction to our park. I mean, why are they allowing this big giant truck to drive on this wet grass? Wait till you see further down the road over here what they've done. Now remember, this whole park was resodded last year because these guys did the same thing last year that destroyed our park. If you look on the edge of the sidewalk here, you see all the mud and sand. That's from the repairs they had to do from last year when they drove these big trucks in here. I mean, why are they allowing them to do this? These trailers, no matter how many tires it's got, they sink right into the mud. Now remember, this is a playing field. This is a soccer field and it's a football field and it's everything else. You can't have kids running in a field and have the holes and ruts everywhere because they're gonna break their legs or ankles. So our park has been destroyed. So you got all the old mud from last year. Look at this. Look at all the tire marks everywhere. Now right here, you're gonna see a brand new sidewalk. Okay, look at this. I know it's very windy and you're probably not hearing what I'm saying. So I'm gonna go up here and turn around. So right now I'm putting the wind behind me so you can hear what I'm saying. So this is what the city of Halifax allows these guys at Cure for the Run to do. They come in here and destroy this park. They rebuilt the park last year after they destroyed it. It took 3 months and they've come in here and they've let them do it again. And if you think it's only along the edge, this is a brand new sidewalk here, okay? This one right here. And this is all brand new sod. I mean, you add up all the damage that's been done to this park. There's no way in the world that the Terry Fox run, the few people that made some money, and where's the money gonna go? It's definitely not gonna go to fix this park. And these guys think it's funny. They think it's funny destroying this park. Look at it. Look at it. And it's not just here. I mean, they drove anywhere they wanted on this wet field. So now the kids that go to this high school can't use this field now until next year because they're going to have to resod it like they did last year. They keep coming over here and destroying the park every year. Every year. That's like over $100,000 worth of damage. Last year, they spent 3 months resodding this whole field because these trucks left ruts through the whole field. They did it again. There's no way in the world that the Terry Fox run is going to pay for all this damage. This is crazy, man. You need to use a gravel park, an asphalt parking lot. They got trucks that weigh 50 to 80,000 pounds driving and destroying this brand new park. This is all brand new sod. I live right over there and I can see all of it out my windows, right? And I said, oh no, they're gonna do it again this year. They're gonna allow these idiots to drive their big trucks. Even the guy with the garbage, with the toilets, right? I said, why don't you park on the road and put the toilets right there on the grass instead of driving your truck through the whole field to go and spread out toilets everywhere? What, they can run all around the city, but they can only walk a few feet to the toilet on the edge of the road? No, they gotta put the toilet middle of the park and drive there. You should see what it looks like at the other end of the park, man. I mean, I'm doing this video because I'm gonna do a whole series. I'm really pissed off at this. I'm gonna put it online. Take care, man. So, this is how the city takes care of our beautiful park. Look at it. It doesn't look as bad as it is maybe in the camera, but it's really bad. Yeah, run for the cure, yeah. Run away with the taxpayers' money, destroy the park. It's not just the cost of fixing the park. It's the fact that people can't use the park now that they've messed it all up. So let me show you here. Remember, you can't run across a field if you're playing soccer or any kind of sport and hit tire ruts like this, okay? There's a whole bunch of them. They're everywhere. There's ruts here. And if I was to zoom around, let's see if I can show you. They're everywhere in the field. And remember, this is a brand new field. They just resodded the whole field last year and they have to till it like a farm, like a, you use a farm equipment. They literally have to remove all this grass, relay the whole field nice and flat, and start all over again. Because they destroyed the whole field. There's tire marks everywhere. And this is soft soil here. It's a lot of water. So the wind's gonna block me from you hearing me again. So I'm gonna just do a bit more zooming in here and show you how bad this is. Look at this. I mean, how can they allow them to destroy our field like this? You heard those young people talking in the other video a minute ago, and they're not very happy because they can't play their sports, they can't do anything. And like I said, this is the only field that Citadel High has, which is right there. That is Citadel High. And just so it looks really good in the video, because I'm gonna end the video right here for this. And here's Citadel High, guys. It's our flagship high school. It's the most beautiful high school in Nova Scotia. It cost the taxpayers a fortune to build it. But unfortunately, there's no field behind it. They have to come across the street here and use this field. So you tell me how the city of Halifax, the city planners, whoever the hell the idiots are that did this, they should be charged and put in prison for destruction of public property. That's what they should be doing. It doesn't matter if they give them out permits. There's no permission to destroy our park. Thank you for listening. So call the city hall, call everybody and tell them to smarten up. And the phone number is 490-4000.